Hello and welcome to another MATLAB video of MATLAB Helper. In this video, we will be continuing the rest of the analysis for the Indian state Odisha and then widening our scope for the analysis of a nation, Colombia, and then doing a comparative analysis. Every problem has many alternative solutions. So do our SIR modeling codes. Now we have come up with another code to see the analysis and prediction done by it. Now, let us have a look at our next approach, which will analyze the COVID-19 situation in Odisha, a state in India. Before we start the code, we will see a brief explanation about SIR equations which are used in this code.
As we have already seen the different parameters and equations for the SIR modeling, what is SIR modeling, we have known that. Now, coming to an approach to predict the future cases and predict the parameters beta and gamma that will be very essential for us to predict the future cases of COVID-19. So now coming to the equations of the SIR modeling. Here we have used the basic equations of the SIR modeling, that is ds by dt equal to minus beta si. Only I have written that ds can be written as a difference of the susceptible cases at nth plus 1 at day minus susceptible cases at nth day. Likewise, for di by dt is equal to beta si minus gamma I. Di can be written as the difference of infected cases at nth plus 1 at day minus infected cases at nth day. Likewise, dr by dt is equal to gamma I, where dr can be written as recovered cases at nth plus 1 at day minus recovered cases at nth day. Now, using this formula and the data, actual data, we can estimate the parameters beta and gamma. After estimating the parameters beta and gamma, we will now predict the future cases. Now, as we have estimated the parameters beta and gamma, now we have a specific differential equation with one unknown, so that we can turn it quickly into an abstract differential equation of the form u dash equal to f of ut, where we refer to such a problem as ordinary differential equation. A specific equation will have a specific choice of formula, that is f of ut. Now we can say that u dash equal to f of t is a vector ODE or a system of ordinary differential equation in this case. For the SIR modeling, we will be introducing two three elements vectors, that is one for the unknowns, that is u, that we have to calculate or estimate for and or predict the future cases. So first element, first vector, that is u, will contain three elements, that is s of t, I of t and r of t. The next vector will be the for the right hand side, that is f of ut, that will contain three elements, that is minus beta si, beta si minus gamma I and gamma I. Now u dash can be written as this. Now u dash can be estimated as a three element vector, as a vector with containing three elements, that is s dash, I dash and r dash. Now as the equation u dash is equal to f of ut means setting the two vectors u dash and f of ut equal, that is each component must be equal. So s dash will be equal to minus beta I si and I dash will be equal to beta si minus gamma I and r dash will be equal to gamma I. Thus the general short notation u dash equal to f of ut is very handy, and we can derive the numerical methods. Now coming to the equation un plus 1 equal to un plus delta t into f of un tn. Basically, this equation has been derived from this equation u dash equal to f of t, where u dash can be written as the difference of unknowns at nth plus 1 at day minus unknowns at nth day. Since the unknowns has at nth day has already been predicted, so by using this equation we can predict the cases for nth plus 1 at day. And here delta t is known and f of ut is already known. So by using this equation we can predict the future cases.
Now coming to the MATLAB code.
With the help of this code, we will be predicting the future COVID-19 cases. And also we will be plotting the actual data, available up to date and predicted data in a single plot, so that we can get an accurate, so that we can match the accuracy of the of our predicted data. Now coming to the code, in the first section we will be clearing the command window, closing all other figures and clearing the workspace. In the second section we will be importing the daily statewise data from the given URL. First we will be reading the URL by using a web read function and getting the raw data. And then we will be extracting our required data from the raw data. And as in SIR modeling, we need cumulative cases. That is, we need a cumulative data, that is the sum of the present and the previous cases. So, by using a while loop, we will be summing the present and the previous cases and storing them into a array, that is confirmed array and recovered array. In here I am considering the diseased person as recovered person, as they are not going to be susceptible again. So considering them as a recovered person and summing the recovered with the diseased person, I am getting a recovered array. Now we have got the confirmed and the recovered cases. Now we will predict the SIR parameters, that is beta and gamma, in the next section. As from the derived equation, we will be calculating the parameters beta and gamma by using the actual data that is available up to date. And by using the beta and gamma, we will then predict the future cases. First, I will declare beta and gamma as a global variable. That is, as they are used in many functions, so I am declaring them as global variable. I am considering the total exposed population or the total persons that are susceptible to COVID-19 cases as 40,000. Now, in order to estimate the parameters beta and gamma, we need three arrays, that is S, I and R, that is susceptible, infected and recovered. Infected is same as the confirmed cases, only we are omitting the first element that we have assigned it as 0. So infected will be confirmed, this is same as the confirmed array. And recovered will be same as the recovered array, only we are omitting the first element as we have assigned them it as 0. And the susceptible will be N minus infected minus recovered. Here I am taking the step sizes one day, as we have to calculate and predict the cases on a daily basis. So we are taking DTS equal to 1. Now by using the derived equation, we will be calculating the parameters beta and gamma. Now in the next step, we will be predicting the future cases of COVID-19. As I am doing here simulation for D 365 days, so I am considering D is equal to 365. As we want to predict the future data, we will be requiring the initial values of susceptible, infected and recovered cases. So I am assigning a vector u0 that contains 3 elements, and they are assigned as the first element of the susceptible, infected and recovered arrays, that are the cases on the day 1. And now we will be assigning a function f, and then by using the ODEFE function we will be calculating the differential equation and we will be solving the differential equation in order to get the future cases. As we have already seen, S will be the first column of the U vector, I will be the first column of the U matrix, R will be the third column of the U. As we already seen in the previous explanation, this S will be the first column of the U matrix, I will be the second column of the U matrix, and similarly, R will be the third column of the U matrix. Now, we will be plotting the predicted data, that is S, I and R. And then we will be plotting the actual data in the same graph. As first, we will be making the length of the actual data and the predicted data equal, so that we can plot it in a single plot. So, I am considering susceptible. I am expanding the susceptible array, infected array and recovered array by assigning them with len value. And then we will be plotting the actual data and we will get a plot of actual and recovered and the predicted data in a single plot. Then we will be defining the function that are used above. First, we will define the function f of ut. Basically, f of ut will have a vector which having three elements, that is minus beta si minus gamma I and gamma I. Now we will be defining the function to solve the differential equation, that is ODE FE function. By using the formula, that is un plus 1 equal to un plus dt n to f of un tn, we will be assigning the values, different values to the ODE FE function. So by this way, we have designed our algorithm to predict the actual and the predicted future cases of the COVID-19 cases in Odisha. And we will be plotting the actual and the predicted data in a single plot. Now we will run our code to see the result. As we can see in our plot, we have assigned different colors to all the plots so that they can be distinguished from each other. And we have also assigned the legend for the different colors of the plots. So, as we can see, we have in a single plot, we have got the predicted data and the actual data. Here the purple line indicates the actual susceptible cases and the blue line is the predicted cases. As we can see, they both of the actual data and the predicted data are nearly coinciding. And here the red line, the red plot indicates the actual infected cases, that is the actual data, and the yellow line is the predicted data, and we can see that they are nearly coinciding. And here the black line is the actual recovered cases and the green line is the predicted recovered cases, and they are also nearly coinciding. So as we can see that from the first day and at the end of 258th day, we can see that the infected cases has descended to zero. So we can say that after 250 days, we will have zero COVID-19 cases in Odisha, and all of the COVID-19 cases will be recovered by then. So this is the SIR modeling for the Odisha, and we have successfully plotted the predicted and the actual COVID-19 cases in Odisha.
Until now, we have seen COVID-19 analysis for different states in India with different approaches. But now, we will see the COVID-19 situation and their SIR model analysis with another new approach for country Colombia. This will help us to see what the difference is between both the countries in this situation. Before we start the code, we will see a brief explanation about SIR equations which are used in this code.
For modeling the spread of COVID-19 in Colombia, we have chosen the SIR model. It counts with a set of three differential equations that shows the behavior of three variables: susceptible people, infected people, and recovered people. As you see, this model depends on three parameters: beta, gamma, and n. The first and second are related to contact rate and recovery rate. And finally, n is related to population. Population will be defined for me, while beta and gamma will be computed. For this, we are using first and third differential equation, having into account that we can isolate beta and gamma and for every step of the simulation. Doing this, and since we have a nonlinear model, we can compute different values for beta and gamma. Finally, a simple approach is taken. To obtain a unique value, we take the mean value of this. First, we do the processing data. For this, we use the function read table to collect the information of, in this case, this file. And then we extract the information about rows and columns of the data. Then we define the time vector. Next, we define the number of population that, in this case, is over 100,000, and then according to the data that has been extracted, we use table to array function and select the respective column in order to get infected real individuals and recovered real individuals. So then, as you have seen in the model, this depends of two parameters, beta and gamma. So for computing beta and gamma, we use the next lines of the code. This one exactly. They are computed according real data collected and the model equations. Also, some conditions have been added. In order to avoid none or infinity values, we add the next conditions, these ones for beta and these ones for gamma. Now, for plotting the model, we set the initial conditions according to the model. So we add initial condition for susceptible person, infected person, and recovered person. The time simulation is for during 365 days, and then using OD45, we resolve the differential equations and then we plot the requested information. So for this case, we plot infected, recovered, and susceptible person. And here we add some plot properties like a title, X label, and Y label and finally, here we can see the function to represent the three differential equations for SIR model. Then we run the code and we have this. As you see, the information about susceptible, infected, and recovered people is shown. Infected people increase until a peak value is met over 200 days of the epidemic, while recovered people start to increasing, and since this happens, the number of susceptible people decrease.
Now summing our analysis and coming to a definite conclusion, India's COVID-19 case tally climbed from 100 to 1 lakh in just 64 days. Data sourced from the Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has revealed. On comparing this with global data sourced from world meters, it has been found out that India's rate is more than double the number of days when compared to Colombia. Now it's in our hands. We need to take our responsibilities, and by this, we can contribute a lot more to the nation. Now let's have a quick view of the precautions. Thank you for watching this video. Do like this video if you found it helpful. If you have any queries, post it in the comments or get in touch with us. Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Education is our future. MATLAB is our feature. Happy MATLABing!